我们选择在乌托邦平原南部来进行着陆的话呢，实际上有两个方面的考虑，综合考虑的结果。一方面是什么呢？我要保证我的着陆安全，因为我们毕竟是第一次去，安全着陆是我们后续开展科学研究的前提。你不能安全着陆，哪有后面的科学研究呢？ 所以，这是第一个考量。那么，乌托邦平原相对平缓。第二个呢，我们是从科学探测的意义这个角度考虑。那么，我们的科学家认为，我们着陆点附近呢，应该是古海洋与陆地的交接面。
嗯哼。
哎，认为这一附近。
开展科学探测的意义、潜力巨大，所以综合考量，选定这个点。我们有五大科学目标啊，包括火星表面的地形地貌、结构构造的一个变化的情况，还有一个我们会探测火星的地下结构，甚至可能看看火星有没有水，后面对于人类的开发或者是宜居有没有可能性的，都是我们一个探测的一个目标吧。
Well, we're all really excited about this because this is a scientific expedition, very comparable to many of the ones that we're trying to do in other parts of Mars, but unique in its own right. For example, it landed in the northern lowlands, which is below what is believed to be an ancient shoreline. So it may be actually on the floor of an ancient billions of year old ocean. And we're very excited about that. We haven't really been in this area before like this. And it's got a lot of promise for fundamental scientific questions like the origin of life, for example. Can tell from the multispectral images, instruments, what these rocks are made of, and that's really important. Is it sedimentary rocks? Is it a lava flow? Is it some combination of these? And of course, we'll be looking at the images to determine what, in fact, there could be fossils there. There could be fossils. So we've been looking for those, obviously, as well. In addition to that, the ground penetrating radar will give us an idea of whether there's ice, maybe a frozen ocean below. So this is very, very exciting.